I am going to discuss very important rules, or you can call it as laws. These are termed as Kirchhoff's rules. Why Kirchhoff's rules are so important? Because these rules gives you perfect solution related with electrical networks. What is an electric network? An electric network is a complicated electric circuit. As we know, Ohm's law is failed to answer or failed to answer the questions related with electric network. So here is the point where Kirchhoff's law and Kirchhoff's rules work. So what is Kirchhoff's rule? See, first rule is called junction rule. What is the statement of junction rule? It states that for any given junction of an electric network, the total algebraic sum of the currents at a junction is always zero. You can say mathematically you can put it as sigma I equals to zero. So junction rule or Kirchhoff's first law basically justifies law of conservation of charge. Now what is junction? Let's take, assume a cubical structure, and in each arm of the cubical structure there is resistance, and this is the point where EMF cell is connected. Each arm is having resistance. These are the points in electric network where we have more than two connections are termed as junctions. So you can call it as junction J1, J2, J3, J4, J5 and more. 8 junctions you can opt. Now, do I need to deal with each and every junction in every problem? Answer is no. That you will do as per your requirement. So this rule is applicable at a time for one junction. Any one junction you choose as per your requirement. Now, how do you apply this? Sign convention is, suppose this is junction J, and there are so many connections and so many paths through which current is coming, leaving junction. So I have shown you here in the figure at junction J, 5 path aapko dikhaye hain. I1, I2 current junction mein enter kar rahi hai. I3, I4, I5 current it leaves out of the junction. So when you apply junction rule, the current which is approaching to the junction is taken as positive. Remember sign convention. I repeat, the current approaching to the junction is always taken as positive, and the current leaving out of the junction is taken as negative. So I1 plus I2 minus I3 minus I4 minus I5 equals to 0. This will be an open version of sigma I when you apply. So this will vary according to your junction. It would depend ki kitne path se current enter kar rahi hai, kitne se ja rahi hai. But for any junction, essential condition is that there should be at least one inlet and one outlet. Right? junction cannot be possible like this, that all currents are approaching to the junction and it is not leaving out. This is not possible. No current is approaching to the junction and currents are leaving out of the junction. This is also not possible. Remember these points. Right? Second rule is, loop rule or mesh rule or Kirchhoff's second law. What does it say? It states that total algebraic sum of changes in potential around a closed loop is always zero. I repeat, the total algebraic sum of changes in potential around the closed loop is always zero. So mathematics expression, you can say sigma v is equal to 0, or you can put it as sigma I r is equal to sigma v, right? That is total potential difference across resistors in the loop, sum of that is equal to a total sum of the EMF of the cells in the loop. What exactly we mean with closed loop? Closed loop is the path, closed path in the network. Like this, we can say A, B, C, D. Let's remove. Let it be. I'm not writing C, D. J1, J2, E. Then we can say C is here. So A, B, J1, J4, A is one loop. Likewise, J1, J2, J3, J4, J1 back to the J1 is second loop. Likewise, you can keep on choosing each of the surface of the cube, cubical structure will be one loop. Apart from that, you can choose any loop. You can start from A, if I mark this point as E, then A, J5, E, A. A, J4, J3, J5, E, A, B, J1, J2, C, J2, E. So what actually is a closed path? It starts from a single point in the network and comes back to the same point. Only condition is that you are not allowed to repeat the path. You cannot do like this. A, B and comes back to A. You cannot also do like this. A, B, J1, then you comes back B and A. No. You have to move in a closed path. So you have to choose loops and mesh in the according to the Kirchhoff's second law in a given electrical network and apply this equation, then you get one algebraic equation. Right? This law is basically a law of conservation of energy. Right? Let's see sign convention during motion in a loop. If I choose the loop A, B, J1, J4 and back to A in a loop, follow these two conventions, easy conventions. If the direction of current in the arm of loop is same is same as that of direction of motion take current as positive. Otherwise, negative. Similarly, during motion in a loop, if one interacts with negative terminal of cell, first take its EMF as positive in RHS of equation. Here you have to apply the second equation. Otherwise, negative. What do I mean by otherwise negative? When you interact with the positive terminal first, then you will take it as negative. Now, direction of motion in a loop, during motion in a loop, what? What exactly I mean to say here? Once you have opted a loop and mention your loop, that loop A, B, J, 4, J, A. तो जैसे ही आपने लूप पूरा लिखा, आपने अपनी डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन क्लियर कर दी है. ए से आप बी तक, बी से जे वन पे जा रहे हैं, जे वन से जे फोर पे, जे फोर से ए पर. इफ व्हाइल यू आर मूविंग फ्रॉम ए टू बी, मान लो आर्म ए बी में डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट इज आल्सो फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम ए टू बी, टेक करंट पॉजिटिव. इफ करंट इन दिस आर्म इज फ्लोइंग बी टू ए, then take current negative here in the left hand side while multiplying the respective resistance present in the arm. Similarly, जब आप A से B में जा रहे हैं, मानो रेजिस्टेंस नहीं है, सेल लगी हुई है. जब A से B पे जा रहे हैं, तो अगर आप पहले टकरा जाते हैं नेगेटिव टर्मिनल से, तो नेगेटिव का EMF राइट हैंड साइड में पॉजिटिव रख लेना. And if you are interacting with positive terminal first, then suppose in this loop if I move from A, E, J, 5, तो मैं पहले positive से टकरा रहा हूँ, I will take E as negative here. Right? That's how you will be able to form one algebraic equation. Each loop selection of each loop will give you one algebraic equation. तो किस problem में कितने loop choose करने होंगे, वो depend करेगा कि variables कितने हैं. Because algebraic method says as many unknown variables you have, these many algebraic equations you need. And I repeat it again, usage of one loop or applying loop rule in a one loop will give you only one algebraic equation.